Ze hebben gegeten, ze zijn gewassen, ze zijn aan het drinken, dus ze zijn klaar met het optreden hier bij Blues Festival in Raalte. En naast me zit hier 24 Pissers, all the way from a small town called London, Great Britain. First of all, guys, how was it on stage? How was the reactions of the audience for you?
Yeah, it's great. Fantastic festival, you know. Really great vibe in here, you know. It's nice and big. And it's cool.
That's the way we like it.
I like it big. The size matters.
First of all, for our viewers and listeners for the radio, from left to right, who do we have in front of us?
My name's Julian Burdock, and I play the guitar, a bit of harmonica, and sing.
Silas Maitland, and I play the bass.
I'm Michael Connolly, and I play the drums, occasionally vocals.
Moats Gamble, I play the Hammond organ, sing a bit and run around, just like him.
That's like him. It was a powerful set. If you allowed to play 1 hour and 15 minutes, do you adjust your set on it?
Yeah. We try and make it as snappy and as hard hitting as possible to get the maximum reaction from our audience, you know. And I think today it was all right, wasn't it, like that?
Yeah, we're definitely going to adjust it a little bit depending on what the audience is in front of us, and so react a little bit to the audience. React a little bit to the fact that John Mayall just walked past your shoulder and went, blues legend John Mayall just walked past there. Yeah, but we're going to change our set a little bit depending on what the audience is or what, where we are or what, how we feel, you know, what we want to play. So we're going to change it a little bit. Yeah, definitely.
You mentioned John Mayall passed by, so you want to do something extra, but you aren't. I read some of your bio. You ain't starstruck because you all played with somebody in another way who has a maybe bigger name than John. So,
people, yeah. I mean, we've all done a lot of stuff, haven't we? I've done like Maceo Parker and Fred Wesley and who else? Like,
it's now name dropping.
Yeah, you've done Maceo Parker. Yeah. Woo! Yeah,
you've been too long alone on the road, man.
Yeah. You know, we've all done sort of past life as sort of players, like sidemen on the side.
Paul McCartney. When was that?
Hey, that was at a great gig, which was hosted by Richard Branson. See how many names you want me to drop, right?
De Niro, I can't stand name
dropping. I've seen George Clooney in a movie.
It's like I was to Bobby De Niro.
And I had to play a couple of jazz standards with Paul McCartney. It was tough. It was good. He's actually a really good singer. Not many people know that.
My guess is that
a lot of people know he's a good singer. And I think fucking half the world knows Paul McCartney.
He's also a good artist, and he knows how to pick good people. Well, 24 Pages, you released your CD. Do you have a plan to conquer the rest of Europe?
Yes, that is.
And how is it?
That is the plan.
Conquering Europe. How?
Yes. With effort. We're going to use effort against the European.
Elbow grease.
Dedication on the road.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. I mean, just elbow carry on. Grease, yeah. You know, hopefully we can play more of these festivals. You know, I mean, they're great. You know, and we get like a really good opportunity to meet like really sort of interesting people. You know, and maybe, you know, good connections to go on to another place. And you know, I mean, this is relatively new for us, isn't it? Playing over here in Holland. You know.
Yeah, it's our first year over in Holland. So definitely it's a good opportunity for us to do festivals like this and kind of be here for the first time. It's basically our first time here, you know, so it's like, yeah, it's great. It's all part of the plan.
It's all part of the plan.
I think it was the great Sammy Davis Jr. that said, always give 110%. And that's what we plan to do.
That is what we plan to do, yeah. No, we're going to give 115%, man, because Sammy
Wait. You're giving away the plan, man. Yeah. Don't tell everybody the plan, man. That'll be a mistake.
We're going to give 110%. We're going to give 120%. 120, I tells you.
No, but that's...
Well, that comes in conflict with your other state. If it is fun, we play it, and if it's not fun, we don't play it. I read that in the paper that lies around here. If it is fun, if it's
right, yeah, no, exactly, right, yeah. I mean, if we were doing music that wasn't too much fun, right, you know, we just wouldn't play. You know, I mean, we're all the music we're doing, you know, it's got to be fun for us, you know, otherwise we can't do it, you know. So basically, what we do when we play on the stage is just sort of do the best we can with the music we really like, you know, and that's it, really, you know. I mean, we just sort of put, you know, I mean, as I say, I put 150% in. I couldn't do it anything less. Couldn't do it. It's impossible, you know. You know, just you know, like today we were just doing the best we could, you know, and I think that was the best thing about the gig. I mean, with the time of the day we were playing, obviously, you know, I think that maybe it'd be better when people were a bit more like pissed out at their head, you know, like jumping around and that, you know. But it's like, you know, they're not, so you have to really work them, you know, and get them singing along and that, you know. And I, you know, and I think that was the best thing about our gig today was the, you know, at least that we tried to get the energy going.
That is the basic sort of premise, the basic idea of 24 Pesos, yeah. Is basically for us to play songs that we want to play, you know, and that is it, you know. If we don't want to play them, we don't play them. We got hundreds of boring songs, but we never play them.
The songs you've written for the last CD, who writes them all for you? Is it a group effort, or is it just the guitar player with the brilliant ideas?
No, I come up with a lot. I come up with most of the ideas, right, you know, but the thing is that, as I was saying to my friend earlier on, I mean, it's like, I come up with the ideas and then we all just put our little bit in, you know, and it makes a song as it is, you know. I mean, otherwise, I think a lot of the songs that I come up with would probably be a bit boring, to be honest with you. Like, but what's nice about it is because we're a band, you know, I say, what do you think about this idea? I've got like a little bridge chorus or something, a couple of chords, you know. And then he might come up with like, well, why don't you try it like as a sort of a waltz or something, you know, or for, you know, like, I'll do this, you know.
Or bring another limit for it. You know, there's a lot of influences in the band. We've all done loads of different things and we've all listened to loads of different music in our lives, you know. And so Julian might come up with an idea and I might think, well, What if we played it a bit more like The Clash might play it? Or Mike might think, oh, what if we played it a bit more like Toto might play it or something like that, you know? Or most might think a bit more like a Jimmy Smith or something like that. And when you mush the whole thing in there, it sounds like 24 Pesos. So
you're not afraid to get all the influence you can to make a good song. Yeah, not blues purist.
No way.
That's the whole point. It's like cram as many things in there as you possibly can into that jar, you know. See what happens at the end, you know. That's the idea, you know. As many as you can possibly get in there. And don't never say, like, for 24 pages, never say, do you know what, man, that's not really our genre, you know. It's like, well, rather it's to say, how can we squeeze that thing in that hole, you know? How can we get it in there, you know?
You know what we're saying about that, right?
Not yet.
I told you,
you've
been on the road for a long time.
We have to squeeze things into a lot of holes. That's the thing. And so,
No.
I hope you got all a single room tonight, or double bed and share it.
We have, yeah.
That's live on the road for you. Next thing, you just released a new album, but are you already working on new songs? Is it a constant process, or is it you book studio time for it?
We've started working on the new album. We started working on it last week. We've been doing some songs. We played a couple of new songs that are not on an album. We don't know if they're going to be on the new album, but we've got a couple of new songs. We've got a whole bunch of new material, and we started working on it last week, putting some tracks down and arranging it and getting some ideas for it, you know. It's a bit of a process, you know, but we just started working on the new album, so hopefully we're looking at maybe November for a release for the new album. So
that's pretty soon.
Yeah, that's we're gonna work. I mean,
it, you've got a lot of songs to, you know,
I mean,
do
150%, it's gonna fucking happen. Do you remember that?
Oh, I hate bands who always do 150 or have amps which go to 11.
Yeah, ours go to 13, don't they?
Yeah.
We had some specially made.
Well, are you all musically schooled, or what I always ask, are there any people who can read the music notes?
I can read the music. I can read the music. I don't know who else.
Don't see that too often in a blues band, though.
Yes, I can read to a certain extent. Yes, I can read music, thankfully.
Yeah, yeah. I'm a classical guitar player.
Mark him! No. Do what?
Which went, and it all went horribly wrong.
Well, guys, we're gonna round this interview up. Thank you for your small time, and good luck in Holland.
Thank you,
Moose.
Cheers. Thank you very much.
Thank you.